Hey everyone, this is Dan Reichert with another edition of Replay. This time around I'm joined by Andrew Reiner.
Hey, hey.
Tim Turry.
Hello.
And Phil Kohler.
Hi there.
And we are going to play, I think, one of the most underrated games ever. I mean, most of the reviews were really good, but when you talk to people about it, for some reason, a lot of people really don't like this game or don't have good memories about it.
And I would be one of those people.
Phil is the one here. He's the devil's advocate. Us three... safe to say we all love it.
We're
all
drinking the Kool-Aid. Good games.
What's that?
We enjoy good games.
Oh, I hate good games. Good games are the worst.
This you is... like what was that? Deadly Premonition?
I love Deadly Premonition. That's right.
Ugh. So, we will play this good game here. I was thinking, I was talking to Tim, and like in terms of GameCube games, this is way, way up there, I think, in terms of the best.
I put this right behind Resident Evil 4.
Wow.
Yeah, I'd say 4. I'd put this above Metroid Prime, I think.
Wow.
And above Wind Waker.
Yeah, that's... I disagree with all those things you just said.
I don't know if I put it above Wind Waker.
It's close. I mean, Wind Waker, Prime, and this, I think, are all really, really close.
It's kind of interesting when this game came out because it was right around Wind Waker, and that was focused on water, and then this game came out and was focused on water. It was kind of a weird moment in gaming history with everything being focused on an element.
The GameCube was originally titled The Dolphin, right?
Yeah, it was.
Yeah, there we go.
I think
we know why now.
Interesting. Oh, we're going to go after Petey.
Yeah, we'll start with one of these early levels. This is the first real boss fight in this game.
Is this the first appearance of Petey Piranha?
Yes, I believe it was. And then he showed up in Mario Kart and later games. And so you start out, your basic nozzle, or your hover nozzle here, is that. You get rocket nozzles and turbo nozzles later, and you can switch it to this one here to shoot things.
I just got past a bad case of the rocket nozzles, but I got over it. I got some ointment.
Yeah?
We'll be okay.
Nice. This one thing I really loved about this game is you could just get around the entire game by doing this. Just hitting B and sliding.
It looks pretty effective right there.
I have a feeling that that's maybe the only reason you like this game.
Yeah.
Chocolate.
Yum.
Sunday.
Sprinkler moves.
Reminds me of Willy Wonka.
So, Phil, what's the basis of you just... I mean, would you say you...
Okay, so I should make it clear. I don't hate this game by any means. It just didn't really... I didn't really get into it, and I should also be clear that I didn't really get into Mario 64 either. Galaxy was the first 3D Mario game that I really liked, and I think it was just because the level design was a little bit better in Galaxy and a little bit more condensed, and there was just kind of a straight path where you knew you were going, and I really like that in my Mario games.
So what you're saying is you hate Mario games.
Yeah, so why do you hate Mario?
I love Mario games. I love all the 2D Mario games. But I haven't really liked the 3D ones until Galaxy.
Now, I think that each one has gotten better, actually. Like, 64, I understand its place in history, you know, being the first really great 3D platformer. But then I think this really improved on it, and I think Galaxy is the best.
Yeah, I think they definitely ran with, like, their level design, and they didn't try to get too gimmicky. Like, I think that a lot of people could dismiss the, you know, the splash pack thing, his little water jet pack thing, as a gimmick, but I think it really helped. It was fun, and like the water graphics looked awesome, and what better thing to highlight for a system than like new water graphics? It usually seems to be like such a, you know, like, oh yeah, the water looks really cool in this game, but they made it a gameplay element.
Well, it adds so much to the platforming dynamic. I mean, there's so much you can do with it, and man, does this game get tough as it goes on, trying to get like all the red coins.
Yeah.
Well, we'll play a couple later, but there are one of the signature levels types of this game is when the Shadow Mario, that's kind of running amok through Delfino Island.
That guy's a jerk.
Yeah, he steals your flood, your jetpack thing.
Flood. Here. I said splash. I was thinking flood. It's FLUDD, right?
Yes.
Yep.
Oh, clever.
And he steals it, and basically it's all platforming intensive levels. And you don't even have like the long jump or, you know, moves that you had in 64 or Galaxy. So,
and I will
we'll
say
play a couple of those.
Some of the stuff I did like about this game, I love the weird old school levels where you're just in the weird floating. Yeah, I guess is that what you were talking about?
Yeah, the platforming ones.
Yeah, those I thought were awesome.
And this is the first time that a Mario game had a movie star in it, right? Like this guy was in Little Shop, right?
Yeah.
Rick Moranis couldn't make it for Sunshine. I think he was retired by then.
When was the last time he was in a movie?
That is called a tangent.
So, this game has a pretty messed up plot, doesn't it?
It's basically, they go on a vacation, Peach and, I think, Toadsworth and Mario, They go on a vacation to Isle Delfino, but we find out that Mario has been framed by this Shadow Mario that's putting graffiti all over.
Yes.
And basically, you take this nozzle and...
But eventually, don't you find out that it's like Bowser Jr. and that he thinks Peach is his mom?
Yeah.
There's some messed up stuff going on in this game.
It is, and it ends with this really weird boss fight against just a ridiculously giant Bowser that kind of illustrates how Bowser size has never really stayed consistent throughout the series. Because, like, he's just a little taller than Mushroom Mario in the first one. And then in, like, Super Mario Kart, they're both riding the same size carts. Then in 64, he gets kind of huge, and in this one, he's, like, 40 stories tall.
And then, don't forget New Super Mario Bros. Wii. The Bowser in that is a little substantial also.
Yeah.
I remember the Bowser at the end of Yoshi's Island being really big.
I think that was technically Baby Bowser, though.
Remember? So did this follow the standard three-hit boss fight?
This one did.
Yeah, it's so... So reliable.
Some of them don't.
That's the first time I've ever seen Dan like be good at something.
Well, he's been playing this for the last 2 days, so I think
prepared.
We can get that one, I guess.
I got 120 stars in Galaxy. Tough game.
Yeah, I got more than that. I got the ones with Luigi too.
Oh,
yeah. So
nice. He's calling you out.
All right. Well, who among us fancies themselves a pretty good platformer?
I can do it.
You want to do it?
Yeah.
All right, let's go to one of the stages we were talking about. And if you want to do that, let's go to the... there's one right here you can do. There's also one if you want to go to the beach cannon.
All right. Is that over here? It's been a while. I don't know this map exactly like I know like the Raccoon Mansion.
Yeah, it's that little cannon thing you'll jump in.
So I think maybe the water stuff is what... kind of turned me away from this game.
Yeah, how could you hate this more than any other game? I just don't get it.
I don't hate it more.
I like the way these guys talk.
He hates jetpacks. I think jetpacks are awesome.
How could you hate jetpacks?
Bill really hates jetpacks.
Water jetpacks.
That's why he loves Dark Void.
Real
jetpacks. Game of the year, I think.
I quit.
Do you want to try the platforming, or do you want to go against Mecha Bowser on the roller coaster?
I'm going to try the this business.
Okay. You're going to have to take out a Monty Mole kind of mini boss fight to get in there.
Secrets.
So you're going to go over that way.
Go get that guy?
Yep.
All right. You know what? Another thing that just absolutely charmed, it was total fan service, but it charmed the pants off me was Yoshi. Seeing Yoshi in like in 3D.
Wait, are you saying that you played this game without pants?
After I saw Yoshi. Yeah.
Okay.
Those came right off.
All right. Just clarifying.
Yeah.
For the listeners, let them know.
So I'll get this guy. What'd you call him? He's a what mole? Marty?
I believe that's a Monty Mole. I think he made his debut in 3 on the Air Fortresses.
Oh, right.
Throwing wrenches at you. So what you got to do is you need to spray these bombs with your water and then throw them at the
bottom. Oh, right.
Yep.
He throws little ones when he gets closer, right?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I'll also shoot bullet bills at you. So yeah, it's B to pick them up and then just run at him and hit B. It'll work. I think.
That was a terrible throw.
Yeah, fair enough.
You can hit him from here. There we go.
Ooh. Nice shot.
He likes to really slide. He really likes to go for it.
Are those digital bombs?
Yep. Oh boy.
Not seen them pass.
Take
those.
That. That's curtains for you, Monty. Good day. Alright, I'm gonna go in here and platform a little.
Alright.
So Phil, what do you have against water then?
What I think it was is the...
You kind of need it to live.
Because like I said, I loved these platforming segments. I think the addition of the jetpack just made the platforming a little bit too imprecise for me. It was like a little too hard to control.
I don't know if I'll try for all the coins. We'll see about this.
Yeah, I don't know if the coins are going to happen. You notice the background is the art style from Mario World 2, Yoshi's Island. Just that hand-drawn. Now that, you don't have to go down there. I think that's some bonus stuff.
I'm just going to try to pass it.
Yeah, I think this is the optional thing here.
Oh.
Nice use.
Yeah, try to do that little. Yeah, that little thing. So this is an optional area?
Yeah, you need to go back there and.
Well, I'll just get the scenic route for everyone. This is gonna fail me out if I don't get all the coins.
I'm not sure.
Oh, I guess we'll find out. So, these things are bouncy. You would not think that by looking at them.
You totally would have failed that without the jetpack. Good thing it's there.
Yeah, that jetpack's awesome.
You're right. What happened to
the jetpack? I didn't have the jetpack in Galaxy, and that was still for your
space.
You're in space. You don't, a jetpack would be cool.
Yeah, it was.
But, you're already, free flying, so.
It's just fine, what I'm saying.
Oh, it did fail me out. Well, let's see you take a stab at the Mecha Bowser.
Okay. Reiner, you want to do that one?
No, thank you. Why don't you go ahead?
All right. Unless Phil?
I'd better not.
All right.
Because you guys are just going to be like, oh, Phil sucks at this game. That's why he doesn't like it.
No, I think we've already established that, kind of.
I don't think so.
We haven't come out right and said it, but that's what I've been thinking the whole time. No.
I feel like there's such a strong nostalgia association with Super Mario 64 that once people played this game and it was just a little bit different and people, I have to deal with this jetpack thing a little bit. I just want to, you know, jump in paintings and stuff.
Yeah, and it's not in the castle, you know, that iconic castle. It's this new weird island we don't know with these new creatures we've never seen before.
Yeah. I think fans felt displaced a little bit. And like, these weird, you know, yada bada blah blah guys. I don't know if that's what
they're called. Is that what they're called?
I don't, probably not.
See, Reiner's a perfectly capable way of getting around.
Yeah, he can't do that in other games.
That's how I get to work.
That explains all those scars on your stomach.
Yeah, I got all those bandages all the time.
Yeah. Oh, he hits you right with that electric shell. You don't see electric shell Koopas anymore.
Got the Yoshi merry-go-round here.
Oh, man, look at that.
Pretty awesome.
How could you hate that?
Phil hates Yoshi, too.
Yeah, so I'm a little unclear. Like,
and ice cream. He hates ice cream.
So children. You're afraid of water is what I'm getting now. Like, how do you shower?
I don't shower. You haven't noticed that I don't shower?
Or something, or?
It's a little awkward when Mario bathes you wearing the flood pack, but it really does get in those those hard to reach areas. The rocket nozzle really does it.
It gets right up in there.
Yep. God, he's such a meanie. Why does he have a staff? Yeah, this game looked good.
He's a lot more agile too than Bowser Jr. usually is.
You know, if you wanted to take apart that flood, you'd clearly need a Phillips head screwdriver, a big one, because that's its eye.
Whoa. So, what's the distinction between Baby Bowser and Bowser Jr.?
Oh, this is a tough one.
I know. I think Baby Bowser is the actual Bowser we've known in baby form,
right?
In Yoshi's Island, the one that gets really
cute.
I think the kid, but isn't there also a Koopa kid? I think they're in like Mario Tennis, you can play as Koopa kid. And then there's the, you know, seven Bowser sons from Mario 3.
I'm going to have to do some serious research on this.
I think you've already given it more thought than Nintendo. I think you've already overpassed
there. I bet Miyamoto has, like, a genealogy chart for the Bowser family hanging up in his office.
I mean, if you really think about it, do you think the princess really is getting kidnapped?
Oh, she totally she loves it. She loves the attention.
That's what I'm saying, yeah, like.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm back in the castle again.
Oh, weird. She probably has her own room there. She does have her own room there.
You never hear her like crying out for help, like, help me, Mario.
And even when she does, it's kind of like,
he's just doing all this on his own.
Yeah, it's Mario's a chump.
Oh, crap. I should probably get rid of this.
Oh, wow, blood really helps you out. It's like a Rogue Squadron game.
Yeah, you gotta be careful of the bullet bills approaching from the front and behind, while at the same time, you have to collect these missiles and hit Mecha Bowser with it.
Because he's a robot, and water hurts robots.
Yes.
Yeah. Look at the scale of this game.
Yeah.
And, like, you don't have to forget about that stupid foggy 64 business.
Nope. Looks great. Great draw distance. Great, like, vertical platforming in this game, too.
Uh-oh. Like, this game's so colorful. Yeah.
This was actually possibly my favorite level in the game.
Yeah.
What I did play.
We're hitting all the Phil Kohler high notes for Sunshine.
All right, let's see if we hit him here.
Yeah, I remember when I first got this game, I got it like in tandem with when I was a kid getting like a new computer that could like access the internet well and dealing with that. And I had to make this terrible decision between, do I want to surf the internet, or play Super Mario Sunshine. I chose Sunshine, and I'll never regret it.
When you were a kid.
When I was a kid.
Didn't this come out like 5 years ago?
This was 2002, Tim.
I don't think I looked at your resume close enough.
Tim's 13 years old.
Anything that came out over 2 years ago is when I was a kid.
Kind of impressed by your facial hair now, Tim.
It's an early bloomer.
All right, we've got time for, we could try one more out. Reiner, you want to try a level out?
Not really.
I'll hand it back to Tim.
Yeah. I like playing this game.
Reiner doesn't like actually playing video games. He just likes making fun of me for playing video games.
We'll try another one of the platforming levels. We'll do a non-red coin version this time.
It's actually a sizable chunk.
She could just run away right here.
Yeah, yeah, or she's got the little parachute umbrella thing.
But that's her kid, and that's she doesn't her kid. Want to.
Yeah.
She's like,
she doesn't
want to
abandon him.
Or she could do what she does in Brawl and just hit people with her butt. That seemed to work out pretty well for her in that game.
Throw turnips at him.
She looks younger. Skip this.
That's all right.
That was important plot stuff.
So, get the shine, and we will actually skip ahead to the next platforming segment. Okay, we got Tim Turry at the controls here, about to do another one of the platforming segments.
Where's this one hidden, Dan?
That one's in the dirty lake.
Oh, okay.
Little cave you gotta go in there.
Give that a whirl.
This fun little water slide here. Phil, what's your opinion on water slides?
Oh, I hate them. It's just, I don't know. It seems like too much trouble. They're wet.
All right, Phil, I'm going to play Dr. Reiner here for a second, kind of your awesome shrink.
Listen, you told me that I...
Did something happen at, like, I don't know, a water park when you were a kid? Or...
Reiner, you told me that I wasn't supposed to tell anyone about when you play Doctor.
Dr. Reiner, yeah. This is the one time we could talk about it.
All right,
so you're going to need to get on one of these little lily pads here.
Oh, yeah, these things. Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah, because it's dirty. Dirty lake right now. And they will sink, so you're going to need to go from pad to pad. Got to switch to the hover nozzle on the fly.
Oh, this is fun. I'm having so much fun right now, Phil.
I'm against you having fun.
It really has held up.
It's been hard working with you.
Uh-oh. Get out of there.
All right.
This game has held up so well. Like, way better than 64 has.
I agree with that.
Certainly, like... As you guys keep pointing out, like, this game looks really nice still.
Yeah, this is, like, almost... It feels like it's saying a lot, but... And I know the scale is way less, but it feels like it's almost on par with Galaxy. I know how much I talk about Galaxy's graphics, but this is still really, really good looking.
Yeah, it's not far behind.
So, Phil, what'd you think of, I don't know, I'm just going to pick a game at random, like Heavy Rain.
Oh, I hate Heavy Rain.
Huh. That game also had water.
Do not hate Heavy Rain.
He's telling me today he hates Terminator 2 and Jurassic Park.
I don't...
What do those have to do with water?
They're good things.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
I see.
I'm looking broader here, and just Phil hates anything that's good.
I think
no, I was honing in
joke.
On, you know, like, anything related to H2O.
I'm trying to get in here.
Oh, okay. That's what we're going with. Yeah. Do the little funky backflip.
It's hard to do. It. This may not go well.
Maybe Phil can do that. That's a classic move.
Oh, no. Get up there, Tim.
It's not going to happen.
Okay. And now we're at the platforming segment we were going to.
Can't believe that took 15 hours.
This has that awesome a cappella Mario theme.
Yep.
You got to love
that.
Oh,
this is also one of my favorite parts of the game, that theme.
Yeah, what does this thing do again? This is like that super turbo thing, right?
That's what activates the...
They were doing that the whole time.
You kind of jumped in your seat there. That took you by surprise.
I just realized here, you have the water nozzle here. Do you not have it once you hit that?
I don't know.
We shouldn't hit it. We don't want to scare Tim anymore.
Uh-oh. This isn't going to end well. Are you feeling confident about this, Tim?
Oh, we'll see.
This is day two, by the way, people.
We have been in this room for such a long time.
I'm gonna hit this thing. All right.
Let's go. Got a minute and a half. What are you...
Here it comes. I can make it. Things pointless. All right. Does this thing move too?
Yep.
Everything moves.
Oh, this is like Galaxy before Galaxy.
Huh. Phil likes Galaxy.
Yes. And I like this. I said that.
I'm getting off of this thing.
But right now you hate it. Now you like it again.
Come on!
Now you hate it.
Oh boy. Yeah, right. I'm not going to go for any of these coins. I just want to show everyone the level.
Gets rough here.
Oh, wow.
Oh, man.
This thing's really going for it.
And normally he would not have the hover nozzle right now, but since this level's already been beaten, it kind of opens up the red coin version where you actually do get the nozzle.
Where am I going? I should do one last spin to throw me off. All right. Here goes. I got 30 seconds to...
Oh.
Yeah.
Nicely done.
This thing is mine.
Yeah, that was good. A little trip up here first.
Took, well, wow. You're gonna
you're
die,
just getting cocky now.
This one for this one's for the kids.
For the ladies.
All right. Well, that was it for our look at Super Mario Sunshine, and stay tuned for Replay Roulette.
I still hate it.
All right. Those of you watching have seen what the roulette game is. We've got Reiner at the controls. You recognize this yet?
Yeah, I know what this is. Why? Ugh.
This is your reaction to most of the roulette games, I've noticed.
Seriously? Well, who should I be?
Well, you've got one dead wrestler that died of, I believe, a cocaine overdose. And this is the only game I can think of where you can play as someone who murdered his family and then hung himself.
So I'm just going to hit buttons.
If you want to pick Chris Benoit, you can do
that.
Runaway.
Oh,
it's boy.
It's been a while since I've seen that.
Oh, boy.
Wait, the story here. This is great.
Welcome to the landscape of television now that WWE owner Mr. McMahon controls all the networks. Now you can see his WWE superstars.
Who is that? Is that a homeless person? TV shows
and commercials. Oh, boy.
And though the critics continue to protest, you can't argue with success.
In oh, fact, that's Mr. an informative McMahon chart. Oh my god, these vehicles are awful.
Now, I feel someone, like a boardroom came together and made this game for me because I love car combat. I absolutely love Twisted Metal. And on again, off again, have just absolutely been obsessed with wrestling throughout my life.
Dan, this. I think they had a picture of you up in their boardroom and they were like, what do we do?
Target demographic.
I did not buy this. I did not like this. I didn't play it. I think I worked at GameStop actually when it came out and I popped it in and it was terrible. Let's try exhibition, see who we got on the roster here.
Oh, man. Yeah, let's do Raw.
Not what the Hell in a Cell looks like.
Sure.
All right.
Give us a shot.
Oh,
let's
here
see,
we go.
We got The Rock, of course.
I think that's actually his car.
That's Jared Allen's car, I think. Triple H.
Rama Bullmobile. God, that's dumb.
Notice the front, he has his gold medals.
Yeah, he's lame because he's a real wrestler. Nobody likes him.
Jericho.
So generic. More like Generico. RVD.
Rikishi.
Oh, is there a butt on the back of that? Hold on a second.
Really?
Wait for this thing to turn around. Wait for it. Wait for it. Wait for it. That's a butt
oh
on the
God,
back of that.
Oh,
isn't
sweat.
He The Rock's, like, lover or something?
He's The Rock's cousin.
Oh!
Which is different.
It depends on what state you're in.
Which it's... His finisher was called the stink face, in which he would get you into the corner and then rub his ass all over your face.
That's the thing that
happened.
That
was that his
happened.
Finishing move. Stacy Keebler.
Oh, and then for the reskin.
We got Matt Hardy.
There you go.
Is that the exact same car?
Yes.
These are the Hardy Boys.
Yeah, those are the same thing. You skip.
Those are the Hardy Boys.
Yep.
Let's, anybody tickle your fancy here?
You got Brock, Minneapolis native Brock Lesnar over on the left.
Yeah, nobody from Minnesota's ever done anything interesting.
Bob Dylan? Prince?
Pick Triple H, because...
Game Informer magazine.
For those watching, Game Informer magazine is based in Minneapolis, Minnesota.
Cool. What planet are we on?
This is the Hell in a Cell level, which I don't understand at all. WWE.
Oh, there's a sarcophagus. Is sarcophagi?
I'm just gonna go drive right into that.
Oh, you missed his Titantron video.
What is around your vehicle?
There is so much HUD stuff here.
It's like handicap rails around your. Oh, look at this! You are playing this game. Shooting laser beams.
Yeah, it looks like Vince McMahon invented lasers. You think he'd share that with, like, the military.
This is a TIE fighter.
Yeah, this isn't set in the future.
My car's like ice. Look at this.
Is Chris Benoit's car just invisible?
I think so.
Oh, he's somewhere else in the map. They did a terrible job of illustrating that.
Technically, this is a dystopian future where WWE programming has taken over every TV station, as we saw in that intro.
Which I just don't think that would happen. I don't see them
taking
over Viacom or... No, I just don't see it happen.
We're somewhere else now. Look at those jackals. Those look beautiful.
Look at all the people in the crowd taking pictures. They're loving this.
Oh, you gotta love that one note the engine hits and sustains.
So, Reiner, outside of the absurd concept, does it actually play all right? I mean,
no, it's terrible. I mean, look at this.
You got a grenade launcher.
Well, okay, our first replay was Twisted Metal, and we went through the whole series. Is this worse than 3 and 4 in Twisted Metal?
I'd put it right on par with those, I guess. Well,
okay.
I did have fun with those games to a certain extent, and I'm sure I could find a way to have fun with this, maybe. Ugh. Maybe not.
You could probably recycle the game case and make something fun out of it. Like some coasters.
What was Booker T shooting cookies at you?
All right, Tim's going to pull.
I'm going to try. I'm just going to... Oh, that's the reverse button. All right.
Now, to use your weapons, it's actually this weird purple button behind the triggers, and I can't even remember... What was the name of that
Z,
button?
I think.
That's a Z? Okay. Just one bumper.
Oh, this guy's going to get it.
That's Kurt Angle.
Sure.
Ugh. He's a real wrestler.
You got Benoit mocking you over there. Brock Lesnar's a real wrestler.
Yeah, nobody likes him. Surprise, surprise.
He's known to be a bit of a jerk. He's from Minnesota, though, isn't he?
Oh,
well, that makes sense.
Well, there you go.
Yes.
Hey, eat that. You actually took someone out.
Yeah, that happened. Oh.
You're pretty good at this game,
dog.
Tim.
Eat dog. No, I'm not. I've never played this before. What? What were those physics? Nah, you don't get those. Come on now. Oh, that's such a in this special button can.
People,
oh, I hate
people should know that Tim talks like this to all of his games that he plays.
This GameCube controller isn't laid out the best. I'm going to go ahead and say that. All right. Well,
It just has a great feel to it, doesn't it?
What you got
to
do is you got to buy the special controller.
Is your laser just shooting over the top of that car?
Yeah, I mean, it's an intimidation laser. It's not really... It's like a warning shot.
The laser pointer.
Yes, I'm pointing where he's going to go to heaven later when I kill him at a later date with better guns. Yeah, I lost. I'm okay with a defeat in Crush Hour. I'll take that. Is that a companion cube?
Do we want a rematch?
No.
I don't think so. I think that'll be it for
this
replay this week.
Quit this game forever, but... Oh, I'm sure. How do you jump out? He doesn't want to jump out of the water.
You gotta, like, just not be down at all. You gotta be, like, right on the cusp of it and hit A.
There's no cusp. It's a log.
I'm talking about when you're in the water.
I was in the water the whole time. I died in the water.
So I should make it clear. I don't hate this game by any means. I still hate it. I don't hate this game by any means. I still hate it. I don't hate this game. I still hate it.